Hello and welcome. My name is Faz Kareem, and I want to spend some time talking about a pretty cool online video editing and collaboration tool known as Oslo. Now, in this video, expect to learn about the basics of Oslo, like how we can create new projects, add new media. Once we cover the basics, we'll talk about animations. And in case you do need to work with others, Oslo can also collaborate by inviting others to work on the same videos. If a video project needs to be uploaded to YouTube, you can connect your account, upload directly to YouTube, and of course, take the next steps in YouTube Studio. Oslo also has some advanced features for video filters and tracking speed and filter settings that we'll go over today. Let's get started. I went ahead and logged into oslo.io. And from here, I'm able to view my projects. I'm currently in the demo project that comes included with my account. But if I need to switch to projects, I can go to the example project that I created earlier or create new video projects entirely. Now in the video editing segment, I can create new video projects. When I click on this dropdown here, I can see all the supporting assets that are included inside the demo project. I haven't exported any videos yet, but if I had, I can view them directly from here. And if I am working with others, I can create file request links, as well as view review links from here. The chat area becomes useful once I start inviting others to the project. Let me head over to the video editing area and create a new example project so we can talk about how we can insert media. Now that I'm inside of my example project, keep in mind I can always go back out here, and I can go back into the example project. I can click on this ellipses to rename it or delete it, but let me go back into it here. And I also want to just expand the media panel a little bit there. And down below, of course, I get to see my timeline, which at the current moment doesn't really have any media in it. Now keep in mind, if I had to upload any videos, or any media, I should say, I can do that directly from this plus sign or this little box here. I can directly upload from my computer. I can also click in this little hyperlink area, it does the same thing. Once you have media imported, you can choose to filter between the media by video, audio, or images. Now keep in mind, when you are creating output, you can choose the settings for your output, like landscape for YouTube, that's the default, as well as portrait for TikTok and YouTube Shorts, and square for Instagram and Facebook, as well as changing the background color. Let me head back over to the media area where I can view my media files and add them to the timeline. Right below media, I have a sound tab where I can browse the sounds by category and choose to insert them into the timeline, as well as the transitions. Down below the transitions, I have text. And if I do decide to insert text, I have an advanced tab here that allows me to include animations for text as well. Let me go ahead and delete that off the timeline for now. And I'll delete this track that I created. Down below text, I have filters and a comment section for the videos. Now that we've done a little bit of an overview here of the media segment, as well as these tabs, let's play around with the media file by adding it to the timeline and keeping note that all saves happen automatically. Now when it comes time to finishing up, we'll export it from here. Now that we know a little bit about the basics, let me click on this little contextual plus sign to add the demo video MP4 file to the timeline. Now when I do that, I can select the video and even change the duration of it. I'm just going to make it a little bit shorter. There we go, I'll get the first 7 seconds of the video. And I'm just going to grab my playhead at the very top of the timeline and I'll move it just back all the way over to the front here. I can also have used this rewind option. But let me play this. I can use the space bar or the play option from the center. And let me rewind it one more time. Now, with this video file, this MP4, I have the ability to edit Inside of the settings here, I can choose the speed. Let me increase the speed a little bit by 2x and see how that looks. And I'll rewind this just a little bit. And if once I figure out the speed, I have the ability to add in animations as well to the video file. I can choose a fade in. I also have a fade out. Let me rewind it and see how that looks. I have a fade in and out. Fades in and fades out. Let's take a look at hue rotate. That's flicker. And of course, a really cool one that I have here is zoom, where I can control the zoomed area for the end here. Let's zoom in right over here, but I do want to shorten the video for this zoom segment here, just so we don't get the full video. Let's go ahead and see how this looks. Let me rewind it there in play. Wonderful. Let me put none for the animations there, and I'm going to choose to add text as well. And if I want to, under the advanced, I have the ability to change and add animations to the text. I can have it fade in, fade out, or flicker. Let me change the duration of this sample sentence here to match the video as well. But let's have it fade into the slide, or fade into the media, I should say. Pretty cool. Even with text. Be sure to check out that advanced tab once adding in any text to your timeline. So we've played around with animations. We've also played around a little bit with text. I'm going to clear some things off my timeline. I'm going to right-click and delete this text here. I'm also going to right-click and delete this clip and kind of clear off these tracks that I have just to go back to the beginning there. Notice how all of these things are being saved automatically. I want to talk a little bit about collaboration coming up next. Let's talk about collaboration. I'm on Oslo.io, and I'm looking at the demo project from my previous videos. If I need to share this with others, I can invite members to this project directly from my account. Looks like I've already invited someone here. I can add their email address and hit invite, and I can even change the settings. By default, it's stuck on editor. I have a setting for admin to give complete access rights to the projects, and they're also able to add or delete members. Or viewer, which can view and leave comments on assets in a project. And I also have a limited editor, which can access or edit files specified by the admin. Once you share these projects or invite others, you have the ability, of course, to go into these projects and work on them with others that were invited. Keep in mind, there is a comments area that you can use to add comments at certain segments of the video, where a user can reply, resolve, or like the comment. These comments can be sorted by author, newest, oldest, resolved, or the timestamps in the video. Let me head back over to the project pages where I can view my demo project. There's also a collaboration area where I can create file request links. Looks like I have one created over here that's currently active, but there's been zero uploads. I can share this link with others to upload files to this project. Creating these are simple. I can click on New Request from here, and I can choose to require authentication and choose to set a link expiration date and also include a passcode to protect our files. At the very bottom here is where I can copy the link, and if I need to, I can recopy it to my clipboard directly from this page. I can also chat with others directly from here. Let's talk about what we can do to upload this video to YouTube. Once you've gone over to the settings, and under general settings, you get a prompt to link your Google account directly from here. Now, once you've linked the Google account, you can go ahead and hit the back arrow, and it needs a Google account with a YouTube channel. Once you click export here for your videos, you have an option to publish to YouTube when exported. Now, some advanced features that I want to show about Oslo before we end this video is if you do select these tracks, I have the ability to use the filters area for my videos and apply filters to them. Here I can toggle between the black and white, emerald, sapphire, moody, dull, warm, and amber filters. Also, if I have an audio file, I'm going to select this audio file. I can go over to the settings here, and I can choose to adjust the track speed. And also have it fade. Let me rewind this and see how this all looks. I hope this helps. All right, my name is Faz Kareem, and this was a video on Oslo, online video editing and collaboration for YouTubers. Thank you, everybody.